What kind of relationship does income have?
Direct.
Yeah, for what though? There's two types of goods, right?
Normal.
You have normal and so income elasticity, yeah, that's right, inferior good. So income elasticity of demand. So when we talked about the non-price factors, we talked about income, there were two types of goods, right? A normal good and an inferior good, okay? So the income elasticity of demand measures how a change in income affects the quantity demanded, okay? So it measures how much or how, I'm sorry, how a change in income affects the quantity demanded for a good. Okay? So now we're looking at income. And just in the same case with the cross-price elasticity, we have two cases, right? We have a normal and inferior good. So to calculate the elasticity of income, take the percentage change in the quantity demanded over the percentage change in the quantity demanded over the percentage change in income. Okay? Which would be the same way. You would take the new value minus the old value divided by the old value for both the quantity demanded and the percentage change in income. So now, just as we saw with cross-price elasticity, if the elasticity was positive, what would that mean?
It would be a normal or superior.
It would be a normal good, right? Because it has a positive. So if we're looking at, let's say we're looking at the market for new cars, here's the market for new cars. And let's say income goes up by 10%. What do you think is going to happen for the market for cars?
It's going to increase.
The demand will increase, right? So there will be a shift right. So demand will increase here. And so we want to know what this percentage change is, percentage change in quantity, given that percentage change in income, right? And so if it's positive, then we know it's a normal good. Because income went up, demand increased, right, for new cars. Therefore, it's a normal good, okay? So if elasticity of income is positive, then we know the good is a normal good. Okay? Same thing as if we were looking at, let's say that we were looking at, let's say this is the market for spam. It's P1 quantity 1. So, if income went up, how do you think that would affect the market for spam?
Down.
It would go down, right? So there's a negative relationship. So the demand curve would shift. This would be the new equilibrium quantity. So there would this percentage change in quantity is what we're concerned about with the percentage change in income. So in this case, the quantity went down, right? So income went up, and the quantity went down. So therefore, the elasticity is going to be what? Negative, right? So if the elasticity of income is negative, then we know the good is an inferior good, right? And same thing applies as cross-price elasticity. So the negative and positive relationship is important to us. Because when it's very important to economists and people, right? If, let's say, you sell spam, it's really important to know how income affects your good, right? Because if the economy goes into a recession, how do you think that's going to affect their good? There's going to be an increased demand for their good, which is good, right? So they're a counter-cyclical commodity, okay? So it goes the opposite with the business cycles. So if there was economic growth and people were starting to get new jobs, people were getting raises, then that would affect their good as well, right? And the same thing applies as with the elasticity. So if the elasticity is greater, so if the elasticity of income is greater than one, then there's a strong relationship. A strong relationship between income, okay? And if the elasticity of income is less than one, then we know then there is a weak relationship. So these are very important things to economists and to firms, right? Because they want to know these relationships. They want to know how people's income affects the quantity demanded of their good. They want to know the cross-price elasticity of other goods, of complements and substitutes, because it affects their market, right? And so that's the idea.